Thank you. A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
How delightful! Another letter from our erstwhile listeners. What's up, honey? Me and my sister love you. Oh, that's nice. Y'all got clarinets and violins, but you got something most music these days ain't. Oh, let me guess. Lineage traced back to the great Haydn himself? Let's see here. Y'all got soul. Oh, yes, soul. A raison d'être. Delicious. delicious. My sisters say whoever you got playing the keys got more funk in his pinky. But I told her that ain't funk. That's classical. Yes, indeed. That must be most exacerbating. Classical music has been known since the time of the early explorers. Funk, by contrast, is an entirely modern conceit, and you'll find none of that here. Funk, as they say, is for the layperson. Now, let's hear another one of those soulful cans.
A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Glenda. But apparently, that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage going to make me richer?
By certain metrics, perhaps yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human
psyche. Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
Interesting news from the city's export division. Sources tell us that our city has more services than we know what to do with.
And you know what that means, folks. It means we're not cutting things close enough.
Well, no. The point is we're selling it and bringing money into local economy.
That's right. You could almost say it's too much of a good thing.
Or we could say that we're enjoying a positive trade balance and the economy is booming. More after this.
You're back with Second Moon Radio, your second musical home from home. So settle back in your chair, pour yourself a glass, and prepare for another hour of musical delight. Tonight we are doing a musical tour of Italia, land of art and culture. Que bon, as they say. And an aria inspired by the infamous Vivaldi shall be our guide.
Industry in the region is on the rise, and when business is doing well, that floats our boat.
There's no sinking this boat, Glenda. And on to our main feature story. The commercial district is booming, as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Java mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jim. We'll be back after this.
Thank you.
You're tuned in to Second Moon, the channel where the classics never grow old.
This just in from traffic. If you're thinking about hitting the streets, you can expect delays on the major roads, especially during rush hour.
Good to know, Jim. Seems like everyone is in a hurry to get somewhere fast. It's worth slowing down. And if you can, plan your trip outside the rush.
Oh, I don't know. I'd rather wait an hour in traffic than have to start thinking about everything all the time. Besides, if I did that, I'd never get anywhere. We're live, and we're getting reports about a traffic accident somewhere in the city.
Road maintenance services have already been dispatched, and traffic flow should return to normal. But if you're planning a quick trip out, you might want to wait a little while until everything clears up.
If you're in it, you already know about it. No use reminding you. Meanwhile, expect delays and drive safe.
Thank you.
What kind of future does music have if it doesn't look to its past? Well, I say the question speaks for itself. Here on Second Moon, we know you can't move forward unless you keep both eyes steadily trained on what's behind you.
Our story this hour, Kim is unseen outside and... abandoned building.
That's right, Jim. This decaying shell is a symbol of the industrial decline sweeping the city. People are being laid off. The industrial sector is on the verge of collapse. And worryingly, crime is on the rise.
Thanks, Kim. Always gotta watch out for crime. Not to mention collapsing buildings. We'll have more after this.
For our feature story, we're on the streets with Kim this hour, taking the pulse of the city. So, Kim, what's the word on the street? Tell us what you're hearing.
It's more what I'm smelling, Glenda. I have to say, it just plain stinks around here. Gross. And these concerned citizens agree.
That's hardly news. There hasn't been any trash collection for who knows how long. There's rotting food, dirty diapers, fish guts, and... Oh, God, I just can't stand to think about it, let alone smell it. And the piles of... filth just keep growing and growing and growing and growing!
Can it, Eugene? We're not doomed.
You heard it here, folks. We're not doomed. It's still pretty stinky, though.
That's good to hear, Kim. We'll be back after this.
Thank you.
A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
You're listening to Second Moon, the station for the cultural sophisticate who doesn't fear extending their ears to the more challenging sphere of the classical genre. Let us move now from the musical page to the literary. Here we have some perfectly anguishing correspondence from a listener. My dear Professor Hornbuckle, whereas I make no apology for my erudite, modesty demands that I prevaricate against the title. I am but a humble devotee of the form, and all my expertise derives merely from a life devoted to the gentle arts. Though I do thank you for the honor, but I digest, to continue. Professor Hornbuckle, as a traveler from my homeland, I long to hear a tune that speaks to the anguish of my road-weary soul. There now, my good fellow, chin up, as it were. No need to wallow in sediment. Leave that to those poet chaps, eh? Here's a tune just for you, and I do hope it provides your aching spirit some modest desolation.
And on to our main feature story. The commercial district is booming, as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Java mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jim. We'll be back after this. Interesting news from the city's export division. Sources tell us that our city has more services than we know what to do with.
And you know what that means, folks. It means we're not cutting things close enough.
Well, no. The point is we're selling it and bringing money into local
economy. That's right. You could almost say it's too much of a good thing.
Or we could say that we're enjoying a positive trade balance and the economy is booming. More after this.
Thank you. Has anyone seen my keys? My keys! What? We're on the air?
Oh! Sorry about that. It's, nothing important. I just lost my keys. I'm sure they'll turn up. They're for the brown sedan parked outside the radio station. Oh, wait.
I probably shouldn't have said that. If anyone finds them, please, don't steal my car. I mean, the old Hornbuckle mobile, please.
Oh, good. Here they are. Well,
never mind then.
Thank you
for listening to Second Moon.
This just in from traffic. If you're thinking about hitting the streets, you can expect delays on the major roads, especially during rush hour.
Good to know, Jim. Seems like everyone is in a hurry to get somewhere fast. It's worth slowing down. And if you can, plan your trip outside the rush.
Oh, I don't know. I'd rather wait an hour in traffic than to have to start thinking about everything all the time. Besides, if I did that, I'd never get anywhere. We're live, and we're getting reports about a traffic accident somewhere in the city.
Road maintenance services have already been dispatched, and traffic flow should return to normal. But if you're planning a quick trip out, you might want to wait a little while until everything clears up.
If you're in it, you already know about it. No use reminding you. Meanwhile, expect delays and drive safe.
You're listening to Second Moon, the epitome of classical listening at home or wherever you roam.
Industry in the region is on the rise, and when business is doing well, that floats our boat.
There's no sinking this boat, Glenda. Our story this hour, Kim is unseen outside an abandoned building.
That's right, Jim. This decaying shell is a symbol of the industrial decline sweeping the city. People are being laid off. The industrial sector is on the verge of collapse. And worryingly, crime is on the rise.
Thanks, Kim. Always gotta watch out for crime, not to mention collapsing buildings. We'll have more after this.
Thank you.
driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
This is Second Moon Radio, classical for the modern age. Unlike most modern music, classical has always been penned by someone sitting in front of a sheet of blank paper, using only their imaginations as guides, through a silent, audio masterpiece. Now, here we sit, listening at full volume, and our souls are transported. But let us not tarry. On to the next rapisode.
A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Glenda. But apparently that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage going to make me richer?
By certain metrics, perhaps yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human
psyche. Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
For our feature story, we're on the streets with Kim this hour, taking the pulse of the city. So, Kim, what's the word on the street? Tell us what you're hearing.
It's more what I'm smelling, Glenda. I have to say, it just plain stinks around here. Gross. And these concerned citizens agree.
That's hardly news. There hasn't been any trash collection for who knows how long. There's rotting food, dirty diapers, fish guts, and... Oh! God, I can't stand to think about it, let alone smell it. And the piles of filth just keep growing and growing and growing and growing.
Can it, Eugene? We're not doomed.
You heard it here, folks. We're not doomed. It's still pretty stinky, though.
That's good to hear, Kim. We'll be back after this.